Hey, have you heard anything about that new movie that just came out? I was thinking about seeing it. Let's check out some reviews. Oh, are we sure these are talking about the same movie? I mean, one says that critics are calling it a must-see, and the other says that it's a flop that leaves viewers disappointed. These reviews are total opposites. I don't know which to believe. I think the problem is that one or even both of the authors may be biased, meaning they are presenting the information in an unfair or unbalanced manner, rather than just presenting the facts as they are. What we need is a way to spot biased information and figure out the real unbiased facts hidden beneath that bias. Let's get into it. We typically think of bias as a bad thing, but it's not. For instance, some people have a bias for long road trips in a car, and others have a bias toward flying long distances. Without bias, we couldn't have opinions, and what fun would that be? But bias becomes a big issue when we're trying to understand the world around us, like when we search for information online. It can result in us being tricked into believing untrue things. Let's learn about some different types of bias so you can avoid falling for these deceptions. When doing research on the internet, you'll run into a lot of media bias, skewed presentations of information in the videos, articles, and posts we consume. But why would somebody intentionally skew the facts? What do you think? Media bias is often used to manipulate people into thinking and doing what the creator wants them to, like puppeteers pulling strings to control their puppets. You should be wary of bias, no matter where you get your information from. Even videos on Mia Academy could have biased information, but we try really hard to keep that from happening, I promise. Media bias can come in many forms, but we'll focus on three of the most common forms in this lesson. One common form of media bias is bias by omission, or leaving out information that might support an opposing viewpoint. You aren't necessarily being lied to, you're just not being told all the facts. If a new game comes out and you read an article that says, "The game has zero flaws and is the best game ever," that might seem a little fishy because no game is perfect. The author has probably omitted some negative information, like the game is basically unplayable because of major glitches. If you suspect bias by omission, what would you do to find out the information that's being omitted? Find out the truth from other sources, of course. That's why it's so important to get your information from multiple sources. Now, let's imagine we're doing research on farming techniques in India. We find a documentary in which an agriculture expert says, "India isn't a good place for farming," while a local woman says, "Farming has been a lucrative family business for three generations." But wait, if her family has been farming for generations, shouldn't she be seen as an expert too? She should be. But the creator of this documentary clearly wants you to take a specific side, so they gave the more authoritative label of expert to the person they agree with. Bias by labeling occurs when sources are labeled differently in order to give more authority to one side than the other. Always be careful of media that labels sources in an unbalanced manner. Hold on a second. I just got a news notification on my phone. And I am furious! Apparently, my city council is stealing our hard-earned tax money for some vain beauty project. Oh, luckily, I'll soon have a lush, tranquil oasis near me so I can kick back, relax, and forget about those thieving city council members. Oh, wait. I think these headlines are actually about the same event. My city is building a new park. It seems like each of these authors wrote their articles to make readers feel a certain way about the park. When you read this headline, you probably feel angry that the city council would steal the community's hard-earned money, while this one probably makes you imagine a peaceful garden with exotic animals. Those intense emotions are on purpose. The authors have used especially positive or negative phrases to make you feel how they want you to, which is known as spinning a narrative. Remember, you're there to get the cold, hard facts, not be emotionally manipulated. But how does bias sneak its way into our media? Well, because all media is made by people, and people have personal biases. A personal bias is when we ourselves have a strong, often unconscious, preference or expectation about something. These personal biases can affect how we treat other people, how we see the world around us, what information we accept or reject, and how we present our own knowledge to other people. There are many different types of personal bias, and each affects how we take in and share information in different ways. Confirmation bias is an incredibly common bias that causes us to only accept information that agrees with what we already believe and ignore information that disagrees. A sports fan with strong confirmation bias will totally eat up anything that says how great their team is and how they deserve to win this year, but they'll ignore or get mad at anything that mentions the team's weaknesses or that predicts the team won't make it to the championship. Even if the negative article is being more realistic, the fan will only read the positive articles because they align with their personal view that their team is the best. They might even be shocked when their team doesn't win because everything they read said it was a sure bet. If you do a lot of online shopping, you might notice that some websites put their highest priced items on the homepage. That's because they want these amounts to anchor in your mind as a typical price for their goods. Then, when you continue browsing and find similar items at lower prices, you think you found a great deal. It's almost half off. It may not even occur to you that those items are still way too expensive because you're comparing them to the even more expensive prices you saw first. This is an extremely common example of anchoring bias. Anchoring bias is when you latch onto the first thing you're told, the anchor, like the more expensive price, and then anything after that is judged against the anchor. To put it simply, first impressions are a type of bias, and they can actually be used to trick you. Imagine that you've cooked and eaten nothing but macaroni and cheese all your life. Since you've mastered the only food you know, you might think yourself a culinary expert. Well, that's only because you don't know how many more foods there are out there. And if you think you're already an expert, are you going to go searching for new recipes online? Probably not. Ignorance bias is when you believe you know a lot because you don't realize how much information you're missing. This can be a huge obstacle when doing online research because if you think you already know everything about a topic, you won't know to search for more information. If ignorance bias comes from not knowing that we don't know something, what can we do to avoid it? Well, I think the philosopher Socrates said it best. I know that I know nothing. Never let yourself believe that you know everything about anything. Always be searching for more information. Honestly, that's just a good life tip. So, what can you do to avoid falling for bias and make sure you're getting all the facts? Well, I've got some good news for you. You're doing the most important thing right now, which is learning how bias works and becoming aware of how it can affect you. Another thing you can do to guard yourself against falling for biased information is to get your information from multiple different sources, preferably sources that disagree with each other, so you can learn the details that one source might be trying to omit or spin. Finally, don't ever, like never, ever, assume that you are immune to bias. Ironically, people who believe they are immune to bias are the easiest to fool because they think they can avoid falling for bias without actually having to do anything. This itself is a form of bias, commonly known as blind spot bias, where we're able to recognize when others are being fooled by biased information, but fail to recognize it in ourselves. Biased information is one thing, but some people actually go a step further. They just post blatant lies on the internet. Can you believe that? And once those lies start getting spread around, it's almost impossible to fix the damage done. A lot of people will go the rest of their lives thinking those lies are the truth. In the next lesson, you'll learn how to evaluate whether information is credible so you can avoid misinformation on the internet. Until then, remember, your brain is the smartest computer you'll ever have, so keep it charged and never stop updating it. See you next time! Hey, hey.